not the characteristic of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam only. Because he took the same characteristics among his people. Then, because he was, when he wanna say something, everybody will benefit from him. There's a saying, the words come from the heart, it goes straight to the heart. If the word comes from the tongue without the heart, it's gonna go in the air. Prophet ﷺ, every single he said from his heart. Why? He was a truthful person. Because the revelation came, he had to say exactly what he said, what revealed to him. And he has to be honest to send the message to others without adding on it or taking from it. It's exactly. That's his mission. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us to be truthful and to follow the steps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You have to follow a few steps. The truth has many categories. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was living on it. To be a truthful with Allah, number one. And the truthful with Allah in his faith, in his obedience, beside in his manners. This is with Allah. Why? Because if you have the truthful that you say to people, some people, they will believe you, but their heart's different. But you are going to be the truthful with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have what's inside your inner, that's what you're talking about. That's what the Prophet ﷺ means, the truth in the life of the Prophet ﷺ. Then, you have to go the truth in your intention. The truth in the intention means your inner must be the same as your external, outside. Exactly. This is the mean intention. Some people, they are very honest in their intention. They are scared to say the truth. So they have double standards. The Prophet ﷺ, what's inside his heart, it's on his tongue. He say exactly. Nothing more or less. Then, you have to be honest when you speak. Honest when you talk. The honesty when you talk, it comes to your tongue. The tongue means, when you say something, you have to say it because you are saying the truth. When someone say the truth, who's going to benefit from him? The one who is listening. Right? I'm saying the truth. Nothing else. The one who is listening, he is the one who's going to benefit from it. The Prophet ﷺ was like this. When he is talking about revelation, the hadith, everything, you find everybody is benefiting from that. For that reason, you find the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ last 1400 years ago until the Day of Judgment. Because it was from his heart. And everybody is benefiting from it. Besides that, if you want to say the truth, also this is when you speak, when you have a testimony, or you are a witness. You are a witness. You have to be a trustworthy. Not because you don't know, please come, we need a witness, come sign. We have it now in the course somewhere, they are doing it. Any stranger come, just fill up. To be a witness, you have to be trustworthy. You have to be known whom you are and to say the truth. After that, when you take some news from place to place, we are talking about the media. The media days, 99% lies, maybe you'll find 1% the truth. They are sending news. There's rarely you find saying the truth. And everybody defend who is supplying them. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he bring any news, he say it exactly, without any going around or playing around the bush. That we have to be like this when he speak. Then, no one can say what everything the truth is good. But not everything you hear it, you say it. It's not a truth. It doesn't include it. It could be right. But you cannot say it as a trustworthy person. You have to be sure what you read is the truth. Any news, you want to send it to others, you have to be sure and affirm that you are right and saying the truth. This is it. This is the mu'min. Then, the truth in your act or behavior. See what you say? Behave. The truth of behave, sometimes many people, they think they are doing the right way in front of people. But their inner, a little bit shaking. Different. For that, it has to be, as we said from the beginning, your inner must reflect on your outside, or your outer side. It has to be this way. Equal. Not hiding or thing, because you are talking and you are acting. Beside that, you have to perfect your good deed. Honesty, this is the truth. Perfect your deed. Be the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order us. Then, come from there, the truth with others, with people. The truth with people is the most important thing. When you, the truth always is a balance, a scale, to make people trust you or distrust you. And remember one thing, in your speech, in your action, or anything, if there's a shaky way, remember that they will never trust you again. This is one of the things with the Prophet ﷺ. He always focused on that and teach his companion, and besides, he is reflecting his behavior on others. That's the way he was. Then we'll go to the point, the truth, what we benefit from the truth. The Prophet ﷺ, he was acting what's inside him as a trustworthy person, as saying the truth all the time with everyone, never hide anything, the news the way it is, that we have to learn. But we have to know what's the benefit of the truth. The benefit of the truth is Allah will answer your dua. If you are a truthful person, answer your dua, number one. Number two, will make the barakah, the blessing in your life, with your family, in your business, in everything, the truth. This is, see the truth what makes, then will make a kind of calmness inside you. Imagine a person who lies. You always worry. When they want to discover my lie. Oh my God, what I said, what happened? You see? When you're saying the truth, you don't care. I said the truth. Whoever can come behind me, let's come behind me. This is the truth. But the liar always worry. Can I come behind him anytime? Then, after that, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the truth, trustworthy person with the truth, elevate his situation or position to the level of pious people. The pious people. Then will take you to pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, under the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to Jannah inshaAllah. This is the truth. We are benefiting from it. And who is those can be the trustworthy person? The way the Prophet ﷺ was. Those are the best among humans. The one who's saying all is the truth. Then, those are people are the people of Iman. The people of patience. These are trustworthy people. And the people of piety, of taqwa. Those are the people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us how to explain how to be. Then I will say one thing, that the Prophet ﷺ, when he is talking about saying the truth, he's saying in the other side about lies. A person who always seeks the truth, and he always seeks the truth, he will be prescribed and written in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a trustworthy person. And whoever seeks a lie, and a lie after that, he will be written as a liar. And he will face Allah in the hereafter as a liar. and he will lose trust in his community and everywhere. And you have to be that many people, they obey Allah. Not everybody obey Allah is that trustworthy. Maybe you find it a little bit tricky. It's true. Looks like, for example, a hypocrite. He will be an obedience to you. And he will pray. But inside him, he's not a Muslim. This is number one. Number two, a Muslim, a real Muslim. He will be a good obedience to Allah, praying among us and everything. But dunya is living in his heart. Dunya is living in his heart. For money, he will do anything. He will pass any prop, anything to false or cheat or anything. But he's a man, he's obeying Allah. Paying zakah, fasting Ramadan, praying the five prayers, everything. As we said, the inner must reflect the outer. We have to. The truth, the trustworthy person, you have to be a trustworthy in obedience. From the beginning we said, As-sadaq ma'Allah, when a truth, when a trustworthy with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to start like this. If you want to obey, you have to obey Allah inside with your intention and outside. Beside that, your inner sometimes will tell you to do something displeasing Allah. Allah doesn't like it. And you are happy that you are obeying Allah in everything. And you are a trustworthy. And this is here your balance. If I will go against the will of Allah in doing these things, what's going to happen to me? Or you find yourself worried. You cannot focus. You cannot focus, especially if you are a good, trustworthy person. You cannot focus until you come back to the truth. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us always. There is another thing. Trust. The knowledge you have, even you are a teacher, or a scholar, or a physician, or a doctor, without the truth you cannot survive. A person going around cannot survive. You could discover, you could do it like any person, but it will be the end with evil. It will never give good benefit to human. Then, and your word, or your work, your deeds, without the truth, it can be more tiring and dependable. See, the Prophet ﷺ, he was following. When he has a knowledge, he didn't say it on his own. He said because he wanna say it on others to benefit from it. This is inside him. Then it goes to the worshipping. Worshipping without the truth could be confusing. It has to be the truth side by side with when you worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then when you speak, a speech, it's free of the truth. It's gonna be a kind, what they call it, it's like a mislead or deviation. You mislead people because your inner different than what you're talking about. And the people, when they find someone, he start to change, they're saying a little bit away from the truth, they start to doubt his sincerity. And they don't trust him anymore. So when you talk, talk from inside. What's inside the heart will go straight to the heart. What's in your tongue and your heart is different, it will go to your mind, then will fly there. Never be firm. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to confirm us in the truth, in the way of the take Prophet Muhammad as a model for us in that, and to speak what he taught us. Ameen, ameen, aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله الذي تغمد الطائعين برحمته والظالمون ما لهم من دونه من وال، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له الذي أمر بالصدق بالأقوال والأفعال وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبد الله ورسوله أصدق من قال من نطق وقال وأصدق من حدث وقال Brothers, we have to know that the truth, when we come here and we see that the Prophet ﷺ had been attacked as a liar, we heard it before when 1400 years they said it to him, and we hear it now, and they start to be more encouraging themselves how to attack Muslims from all sides through their Prophet ﷺ. Not through our personality, through our Prophet alayhi salam. Always, when you find that you have to be to tell the whole world, any world, about the Prophet salam and his sincerity. We see many speech, lectures, talking, this is our Prophet. That's good, but it's not enough. If you want to make to show the right personality of the Prophet ﷺ, you have to act it. And it is not hard. Don't say he is the Prophet. Yes, he is the Prophet, but you are a follower. Without taking him ﷺ as a model, you cannot survive very much as a good mu'min. We have to know that the truth always is a kind of safety and security. Give you safety and security, and it's a way of everything good and a way to Jannah, inshallah. While life always, it is a way of evil, whatever it is, and it's open in the road of miserable life in this life and in the hereafter. Always, and the truth as trustworthy person. Like the Prophet ﷺ will elevate this position with respect among people, among the angels too. But the liars will fall. No one can respect him. Especially when we find a day the lies start to be spread all over. The media is lying. Politicians are lying. People to show you, sometimes they will say the truth. Say the truth. And very honest in saying the truth, but inside their heart they need something from you. They don't mean to say it to help you. They will tell you something, it is right for your benefit, but inside their heart they need something from you. Not because they want to help. Now we are facing it. When you go to investigate someone is questioning someone, they will tell him everything. But why? Not because they like him. Because they need something from him. After that, they don't care. For this reason, we have to follow the Prophet ﷺ from our inner first and to our outside to reflect on all over. This is the way to tell people, this is our Prophet. This is our Prophet. It is in us, not on our in the paper. Not on the microphone and tell people, this he is our Prophet, he is a truthful person. How we know? This is me. Teach your kids, your generation, how to be a trustworthy person. Don't ever allow him to lie even in a joke. Let him be always serious. When he grow up, you will raise a man. You will raise a person who follows the Prophet ﷺ right. Tell him this is the personality of our Prophet, not what you hear. Our da'wah is our personality, not what you talk. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala Ali Sayyidina Muhammad. Kama sallayta ala Sayyidina Ibrahim wa ala Ali Sayyidina Ibrahim. Bil alameen innaka hamidun majid. Allahumma arzukna sabr ala ta'adik. Allahumma arzukna siddha wal akhlasa fil aqwal wal af'al. Allahumma arzukna siddha fil tawakkul alayhi. اللهم ارزقنا لسان صدق واجعلنا من الصادقين واحشرنا في زمرة الصادقين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين واقم الصلاة. الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين.